EarthRunners. Now this is a badass sandal. Look at this Vibram sole here and the canvas top. These are the Circadians, or whatever it's called. Those are not the Elementals, which is the thinnest sole, and of course they're not the Alphas, which is the big sole. Now let me just say one thing before I say anything else. This sole right here, when it comes to comfort and the perfect feeling, this is it. This is the best. Like this, from all the shoes and sandals I've tried, and I have like most of them, this is the best for me, because it is a minimalist sole, but it's not too thin, which of course some people might want too thin, but when it comes to just comfort, when you want a comfortable sole, this to me right now, it feels like the most comfortable Nike shoe or whatever. Of course, I don't like Nike shoes anymore, and like the foam, the active soles and all this stuff, even on Ultras, they don't work for me. But this, to me, this is like, this is a hard sole. This is illegal, look at this. It has no compression. It does not compress, but with the canvas on top, when you wear it and when you're used to wearing barefoot shoes with minimalist, like very, very thin soles, like this thing here, when you're used to this, you wear this and it's like you put on like the most cushioned shoe in the world, right? It's very important. Now, the only difference between the thinner version and this version, and trust me, I had to ask them again and again to make sure I knew what it was before I bought them. The actual difference is the canvas thing here. Like, this is like a small layer of canvas. It doesn't change anything when it comes to the minimalist feel, because again, this is not an actual minimalist sole. It's not like Xero, like this super thin stuff. It does have some cushion, and that's actually a good thing, because it's extremely comfortable, and off-road, you're not gonna be hurt by all the stones and the roots and whatever is on the ground. So you don't have to worry about this one. Now let me just say this, because I watched many reviews, I was gonna get the thinnest version, because even though I'm all into nature and stuff, I think rubber is an amazing material, and my foot on a rubber sole feels amazing to me. And this also maybe, like, as you can see, like the second you wear it, it's gonna get dirty, maybe it will get worn down, whatever. But I got so many reviews saying that you should get the canvas top. And yes, right now, at first I wore it, it felt very abrasive and weird, but then I got used to it and it also got a bit softer, I guess, and now it just feels like heaven. Let me just say though, you need to get a good fit here, you need to get those nice and tight, of course not to the point where they hurt you, but it is important that you get a good fit, because if your foot is sliding on this canvas, it's going to literally burn your soles. This is abrasive, again, it's a good kind of abrasive, but if your foot is sliding around for like miles and miles or whatever, like huge distances, it's gonna hurt your soul, it's gonna suffer. And trust me, I've seen it, like I've had it happen, unfortunately. And also, now also you have like the grounding copper thing, the laces, they have metal in them, so it's gonna ground you to the floor. It works, I've seen people test it, it does indeed ground you. Of course, it's not as good as being barefoot, but it will ground you. Will you feel anything? Probably not. I actually think I felt something when I stepped into some grass, but we all feel good when we step into grass, especially in sandals where you can feel the grass on your foot. So this was probably placebo. I don't know what to tell you. I did not get them for the grounding effect. I don't really care about that much. Even though it has been shown to like reduce inflammation, yeah, it's good. But that's not the main point. I want a sandal that works. And also, I thought they look cool. Now, some people say they look like Jesus sandals. Of course, I put them on. People were making fun of me, unfortunately. But one guy said, those don't look bad. They're just different. And I will say that. In my opinion, those look amazing. Like, I just follow them just for the pictures. Because I just love them the way they look. That's why I got them. I also wear them with like cargo, like green cargo shorts and stuff. I think they just go so well with this kind of stuff. Like, where a canvas shoe would look good, this could also look good because the color of the laces and the canvas. Now, let me just talk about the laces. Maybe If you don't need the look of the adventure laces, get the lifestyle of the laces, because those things, you cannot see it in pictures, man. This is this freaking thing. It could hold down a freaking boat. I'm telling you. These are hard laces. No, it's not because I'm soft. Those are very hard laces. And when I started wearing those, I had to like put some water in there just to be able to bear the pain between my toes. This strap, it would do this like some horrendous, not blisters, it would like dig into my toe, my second toe, so much. It would like make it red, like borderline bleeding. Of course, extremely painful. So you have to break those in like crazy before you can wear them without putting water in them. And when you do, again, if you don't wear them that often, whenever you put them on again, you're gonna feel that this is a hard piece of lacing. Like, you will feel it, man. The feet, there are a thousand ways to adjust this, and that is a problem, because you might actually drive yourself insane, I'm telling you. It's just really weird. But this is the same with most barefoot sandals anyway. The sole, Vibram sole. Now let me just talk about this sole a bit. As you can see, it has like those bumps, but it doesn't actually have lugs. Off-road, it performs just fine. On the road, on dusty pavements, dusty sunburned pavements, this has zero traction. I don't know why. Extremely slippery. Off-road is fine. Of course, I don't have to tell you that this is not that. This is not that. This is the best off-road sole I've tested ever. This is not that. But it should be fine. You know, you should be good. And off-road again, because like with all thong sandals, stability is not up there. You're gonna lose some stability. Then you have to get them real tight. If you get them real tight, they become painful, especially because those are so hard. So yeah, maybe get the lifestyles if you like their colorways. I just love the colorways on the adventures, so I had to get them. Another thing to note here is that those are infinitely durable. I've seen a guy on YouTube who runs like ultra marathons. If you find the video, I'm gonna link it in the description. He just runs and runs on them and nothing happens. I don't know what's like, this is crazy. Those sandals, like, they will never break down. Those things, you will never cut them. Which is why I'm saying maybe go for the lifestyle, because unless you're running ultra marathons or something, you don't need this. Of course, a bit of a design issue here. The laces will go under the sole, which means they will get worn down. But thankfully, they're so hard that I don't see them getting cut anytime. Like, I think this should probably outlive me. Like, seriously, this is extremely tough. These are also handmade in California. So the quality, very, very nice. It's a bit of a thicker sole, but it's very flexible. You will feel it conform to your foot, especially as you keep walking and breaking them in. They're gonna feel awesome. So yeah, I don't know what to tell you. This is an awesome sandal overall. I do recommend them. Of course, I had to get them from California to Europe, so I had to like pay 50 euros for them and maybe 60 euros to get them here. And yeah, so yeah, I paid over 100 for a pair of sandals, which is insane. But it's not their fault, because you know they make it in California, I mean Europe. If you're like, if you are in the US, you should be able to get them for like 50 US dollars or whatever. This should be fine. And again, get the canvas, I would say. It's really worth it. Of course, you're gonna get so dirty, especially if you walk barefoot a lot in your house and your soles get dirty. The soles of your feet get dirty. That dirt is gonna get like glued into this one. Of course, you can just scrape it off, but just wear those with clean feet if you can. Otherwise, you're gonna go black everywhere. They're okay, relatively easy to put on. Not very, like, the laces are hard again, but you should be able to put them on. And you will have this adjustment here. This will be very long. They recommend that you cut it and burn it. Do that, otherwise it's gonna be too long. You're gonna look weird. Basically, you look like the Flash or like the messenger guy or something. I mean, it just looks weird when you have the whole lace protruding through the back. Try to like fold it in, whatever, just cut it, should be fine. But just do that after you're sure of the fit. Do not start cutting laces when you're not sure if it's gonna work out. So yeah, overall problem point, this toe post here is gonna make you suffer. I just keep falling in again and again. I just keep doing it. I will wet it, and again I will just keep doing it and just make it as pliable as possible. Otherwise it's gonna freaking murder your toes, man. That's not good, because those are extremely thick, but I love them for it. The quality, man, those things, you know, they will live forever. You know the sole is good. They're nice and wide. When it comes to, like, they're wide, like, seriously, like, if you compare them to freaking Xeros, those things are wide. This is what a sandal should be shaped, not this. This is supposed to be barefoot, but it's gonna cut aggressively in the front, in the Xeros. Like, your pinky toe is gonna be out of the sandal. Big toe, again, if it's straight, if you manage to get it straight, which most of us is crooked because of shoes, it's gonna get out of the sandal in the Xeros. In this one, no, nice and wide, it looks awesome too. This is how you make a barefoot shoe, like, or sandal or whatever. This is the correct shape. Vivo barefoot, it would be like this. Like, Xero cuts this edge, Vivo cuts this edge. I don't know why, just make it nice and wide. It doesn't look like a clown shoe, nobody cares, it's a freaking sandal. And even with shoes, you can just make it more rounded, whatever. Yeah, so that's it for this sandal. I think it looks good and performs pretty good. And I think the sole is the most comfortable thing you can step on if you're used to barefoot shoes. Again, if you're used to freaking Nikes, no, it's gonna be hard. But if you're used to barefoot, like, with a canvas, oh my god, man, I just wear those outside and they're heaven. As long as you can take the pain from these laces, you just have to break them in. Again, I've probably done like 100 kilometers here on those laces. You have to break them in. There's no way around it. Oh, just the freaking box. This is the best shoe box I've ever seen. It says free your feet. And then you open it up, rewire your sole. I'm not sure if it's focusing in here, but then you open it up and look at this. Yes, random stuff inside. Look at this freaking design, man. Looks so primal. And it's just a cardboard box. You don't have to go crazy, just do something that's cool. I have to be honest, when I saw the inside of this box, I knew I had to have those. Just to look at this box, it's just so nice. Like, it's like you belong in a freaking tribe or something. It's just so primal. Looks good. And yeah, amazing box, amazing sandals, some of the best looking sandals on the market in my opinion. So yeah, no, left one. Yeah, just get those. I don't know what to tell you, especially if you're in the US, you have to give those a try. Again, it's gonna, not gonna be the ultra minimalists like the Xeros with no sole, but you can feel everything, trust me, it's fine. It's freaking great, man. It's just freaking great. Just get them. I'm gonna see you in the next one. See ya. I will eventually do a roundup of all the sandals I own, all the Xeros and the EarthRunners and whatever. Even those guys, maybe. So yeah. See you.